literal characters. This is our third video in our Regex series. So by the word literal characters, we understand that here we have to deal with characters coming from A to Z. It can be spaces, it can be numeric character, anything. Let's say I got a phone and there are numerous chats in a phone. And I got one chat where I just want to find out what kind of relationship these two people maintain. Two people who are chatting on this chat. It can be romantic, it can be secret chat, whatever. But just I want to find out that what kind of relationship this chat has. So what I'll do, I'll take a love sign, or rather love word, to find out this word is used how many times in this chat. As this chat is very long, maybe up to 5 years. And I want to find out how many times this love word has been used in this chat. So here I'll take the help of Regex. And here in this video, we will begin learning the syntax of regular expression by starting just the simplest match of all. Let's say if we have the regular expression that contain love and we have a string just love. So here it will completely match as both are containing the same letters. So it will match a string containing the same characters, which is L-O-V-E. Now, the other situation when we have a regular expression as L-O-V-E, but we have in string love, sick, or beloved. Here, this love word will match the first 4 letters of the string, as this regular expression will not match the entire string. It will just going to find out this first 4 letters of this lovesick word. And in case of beloved, here it will check these 4 letters among these complete string. So it is searching throughout the string looking for a match. It's very similar to search inside a word processor. Matching the literal characters from a regular expression to a string is the simplest kind of match there. The only thing that we need to keep in mind is case sensitive, because by default it is always sensitive. So if I have the word L-O-V-E in capital letters and my regular expression is just love, which is in lowercase, so here it will not match at all. And I will prefer you to write all your regexes as case sensitive. As when we learn about character classes, we will learn techniques to write regexes that match both uppercase as well as lowercase. Let's try it out practically. So for this, I'm on regexr.com. So here to begin with, let's write L-O-V-E in our regular expression. Now in the text, let's write simple love. As soon as I've written the same word, it says that it matches L-O-V-E and also it gives the range from 0 to 3 index. And here also we can see that a complete word is matching as it is turned to blue. Also, it tells down below that L character matches L character and it is a case sensitive, as I have written both in uppercase. Now let's delete this and I'll write L-O-V-E in lowercase. And in string, I prefer to write lovesick or beloved. Here we have a complete word. But if you see it carefully, it doesn't match the whole thing. It just matches the first four letters. We also have love over here, but it will match just the first four letters of the first word. Why is it so? Because I haven't used any of the flags over here. If I use global, it will be showing me wherever love word has been used throughout our string will be matched with this love as it is in blue color. And also it will give the indexes. Now I'll go to my regular expression and will make this small L to capital L. You can see it's no longer a match because here comes a case sensitiveness. If we want to match these, we need to change this L into small, or we have another option. We can go to flags and deleting this global, click on case insensitive. And here you can see it matches the first four letters of love. Here it won't be matching this because I haven't clicked on global. So this is a flag telling it that it should be a special behavior for this regular expression. Normally it is a case sensitive, but now it is using case insensitive. As you can see, that is reflected down. This literal character is a case insensitive. But I'll recommend you to not to use case sensitive as it is not a good practice. If we are working on database, some of the database commands don't allow it. Now I want to show you one more thing. If I add spaces over here in regular expression, and this is a small L. So here you can see it will not match because spaces are also a character. So obviously it will not be matching with our string until unless if you don't add spaces between this love. So here it will be matching this love as it is a same bunch of characters which we have used in regular expression. So as you can see, when I have written this word love in my regular expression, it just signifies the first love, not the other one, because it comes under standard matching and this is by default. So the regex here is doing its work. It's going to read the string from left to right. And when it comes to the first match throughout the string, it will stop. And here itself, it will return. It won't be going further. Now let's just change our sentence which have the word love. So I'll take the string as lover boy is loved by all lovely ladies, just for instance. So here you can see we have this love word three times. Regex by default uses standard matching. Now I want all the love words in my string. So I'll go to flags and will click on global. So here you can see it's going to find out all the matches throughout the text. So love in global mode would match all three sets of love in this sentence with their respective indexes. Now let's have a simple demonstration. It's simple though, but it will be very helpful when we start looking at more complex examples. So I'm taking with a short string, just by a single sentence. In string, he's left of losses loved by loved ones. Here the regular expression engine starts from the beginning of the string. Does this character H matches with my regular pattern? H is nowhere matching with love. Then it will go to next character. It doesn't match, so it will go to the next, then again next, until it finds the letter L. This first symbol L matches with our first letter of regular expression. So this could be the beginning of our successful match. So it will go to the second letter now. The first letter was matching. Now the second letter we have here in our string A, but in regular expression it's O. O and A are different, so it doesn't match. It will start looking for the last character, as it will backtrack by one. And again, it will start looking for the letter L. So now it will move to the next character, then the next character, then now it reaches L. L here we have for losses, rather our regular expression is love. Now the first two character matches, but when it goes to the third character, it doesn't match. Now it knows that L here is not the beginning of successful match. It doesn't just start from S, it has another possibility it needs to consider. It will go back to O and see if O could be the beginning of successful match. Now in this case, it's obviously not. So when we start writing more complex regular expression, it doesn't know that. So it goes to back and try the next character. And then it is seeing that it is not a match. So it will be going further. And when it reaches at L, it says it's a successful match. If it is in standard mode, it will just be giving the first love. But if we are in global mode, then it will keep going until it finds the second love. So here we have two main things. First is backtracking, that it does over here. When it approaches L, then it will go to O. But S is not same as V. So it will backtrack, as regular expression are always eager to return a match for you. And it always moves from left to right and return. And again, it will go for the journey to matches your regular expression in the string. But if you are in standard mode, it will just return the first match they can find. And if it is in global mode, it will find all the letters which are matching with regular expression.